Hello friends, this video on quadrilaterals part 2 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. So now that we have got some idea about shapes, let us talk about polygon. So the word poly means many. So it is basically a shape with many sides. So it is a simple closed curve made up of only line segments. Now this again is important. So it is a simple closed curve. So it can never be an open curve. At the same time, it should never be a non-simple curve. And another criteria is that it has to be made up of only line segments, only lines. Now it can have multiple lines, that is why the name is polygon. Polygon means, poly means many. So many line segments can form a polygon. So the images that you see on the screen, they are all, are they all examples of polygon? Let us try to analyze them. The first one, is it simple? Yes, it is a simple curve because it doesn't cross itself anywhere. It is also a closed curve because it encloses a region inside it. And is it only made up of line segments? Yes, that is also true. This is a line segment. This is again a line segment. This is again a line segment. And so four line segments together form this simple closed curve. So this is an example of a polygon. Now let us look at number two. Number two again is a closed curve. It is also a simple curve. In this case, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six line segments form this. Therefore, this is also a polygon. Talk about this. Here also you see only line segments. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 line segments formed this curve. So this one is again a polygon. Number 4. Here again, this is a simple curve. This is a closed curve. But is it made up of line segments? No. So that means it is not a polygon. When you look at number 9, here also you see that it is a closed curve, but it is not a polygon because it is not made up of line segments. So in this way, you can decide which out of these 12 curves are polygons and which are not. Now, let me talk about one or two examples. Let's look at the image number 12. So when you look at this, it is made up of line segments, right? It is also a closed curve, but is it a polygon? It is not a polygon. Why? Because this is not a simple curve. It is a non-simple curve because the curve crosses itself at this point. So therefore, it doesn't satisfy the criteria to become a polygon, and it is not a polygon. Because many a times what happens is that, you know, children think that in order to become a polygon, the most important criteria is that they should be made up of line segments. So the moment they see line segments, they think that it is a polygon. But for to become a polygon, all the three criteria should be matched. It should be a simple curve, it should be a closed curve, it should be made up of only line segments. Similarly, let's look at image number 5. So here you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So total 12 line segments form this. This is a closed curve. This is also a simple curve. So this is a polygon. So the rest of the images, I'll leave it up to you to decide which one is a polygon and which one is not. Now let us discuss about various categories of polygons. Now polygons can also be regular or irregular polygons. The definition of regular polygon will become more easy when we take examples. So here we will have to ensure that all the sides and all the angles are equal. So let us look at some examples. So when you look at a polygon with three sides, so what is a polygon with three sides called? It is called a triangle, right? Triangle, that is three angles. Now, do you think that all triangles will have all sides equal and all angles equal? No. Not really, because different triangles might have different measurements for their angles as well as sides. But there is one type of triangle which always has all the three sides equal and also all the angles equal. Now what is the name of that triangle? That is nothing but equilateral triangle. So equilateral triangle is an example of a regular polygon. Similarly, when you look at this example where you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sides. So a polygon which is made up of 5 sides, that is called a pentagon. So a pentagon with all the sides equal and all angles also equal, that is also an example of a regular polygon. So this is basically a regular pentagon. Think of a square. A square also has all its sides equal, all sides are equal and all angles are equal to 90 degrees. Therefore, square is also an example of a regular polygon. So regular polygon always will have all their angles equal and all their sides equal. So what are irregular polygons? Now obviously irregular polygons would be those where all sides and all angles are not necessarily equal. They are basically not equal. Either all the three angles are different or maybe two angles are same but one angle is different. So anything of that sort, but here all sides and all angles will not be equal. So think of any other triangle other than the equilateral triangle. So that would be an irregular polygon. Think of a rectangle and not a square. In rectangle, we have all angles equal to 90 degrees, but the sides, all sides are not equal. Opposite sides are only equal. So this side is equal to this side. Similarly, this side is equal to this side. So rectangle is also an example of irregular polygon. You think of a parallelogram. So in case of parallelogram as well, you do not have all angles equal. So in case of parallelogram, only the opposite angles are equal. So these two angles are equal, again these two angles are equal, but not all angles are equal. And the same is true for their sides as well. Opposite sides are equal, but not all sides. So these are examples of irregular polygon. Thank you. Please visit examfear.com for free quality education. You can learn with a simple 4-step learning process wherein you can watch video lessons, you can ask your questions, you can refer notes, and you can take a free online test. We have content for class 6 to 12 on physics, chemistry, mathematics, and biology along with practical videos. So please subscribe to our channel for daily updates. Thank you.